Okay, so I can explain you like how this.
Karthik, how can I record this session?
Yeah, I'll make you as a presenter. You can do that. I mean, I'll make you as an organizer. So you'll have an option on the bottom of link saying that start recording. Right? Did you get that option? See, basically, when you have to explain about your project, right? In general, first they'll talk about, I mean, you need to explain about what is your source system and all those things. You need to do that. So when you want to provide it, see, basically, let me just give you an explanation also in terms of preparing for a Informatica PowerCenter developer, okay? So you need to prepare yourself on the SQL, and then you also need to know the data warehousing basics. And you also need to know the data modeling basics, whatever it is there, and different types of dimensions and all. And I mean, different types of definitions, I mean to say. And you need to know the completely the Informatica PowerCenter, whatever the version that you have learned or your project is on. And you need to know the basic Unix commands. So you need to understand how the Unix commands can be executed and what are the basic shell scripts. And you should be able to also answer in a position that what kind of shell scripts that you have written in a project and how it is being used and all those things, you have to do that. So the first and foremost question, when you go to the interviews, they'll ask you about the project explanation. Okay, so when you want to explain about the project, you should start in a way that what is your source system and what ETL tool that you have used, all those things. So let's say the current project which I'm explaining you about, it is actually about building the two types of subject areas. One is to understand the metrics related to the sales order, and another is to understand the metrics about the purchase order. Okay, so that is a project. So basically, Belcan is a client which actually sells the different kinds of products, right? So if you see the routers, they sell also the cables, they sell the different kinds of networking products and all they sell. Routers, the USB devices, Wi-Fi devices, all these things that company sells, okay? So basically, this project is actually built for a Belcan client. Oh, sorry. Belcan client, wherein they have an ERP system. Okay, so in the ERP system is basically this is an Oracle app system. I mean Oracle EBS. It is, you can call that as an Oracle EBS. In Oracle EBS, you have a different set of tables, a different set of transaction tables. One will store the purchase order related data. Another will store the sales order related data. So you should understand the difference. What do you mean by the purchase order and what do you mean by the sales order? See, basically the purchase order means you are actually buying the goods from another vendor. That is called as a purchase order. Sales order means you are actually selling the goods to some other customer. That is called as a sales order. Suppose for a Belcan, if they have to make a router, right? So they might be needing a small kind of LEDs, LCDs, and for displaying all these things they will buy it from some other vendors. So all those products which they are buying, it will be a part of purchase order. So you are purchasing from some other vendor, so you'll actually go and then purchase. So when you say sales order, suppose let's say you are actually selling all the routers to a particular vendor, so that becomes a sales order. So when they say that, as you know that this Belcan company sells the different kind of products. If somebody asks you like what kind of products your company sells, you can just go on Google it, what kind of products that they sell, that you can understand. So all these purchase order related data and the sales order related data is captured in the Oracle 11g database. You can say that our source system is actually there in Oracle 11g database. Now, as part of this project, what we have done is we have actually integrated the data from Oracle EBS into the staging database, which is also an Oracle system, which is also an Oracle database. This is also being built on a 11G. And from the staging database, again, we have loaded the data into a simple data mart or a data warehouse. You can say that We have built an enterprise data warehouse wherein we have created, as part of this project, we have created a two fact tables. That is your purchase order fact and the sales order fact. I'll tell you what are all the dimensions that you have as part of this and what are all the measures that you have as part of this. So you can say sales order fact. So here you'll have all the staging tables. So something like STG underscore purchase order invoice, and likewise you have different staging tables. So if you want to know the staging tables which are being built and how it is being done, so you can actually look at this. See here, your Oracle database is this. From Oracle database, you have a order related data, invoices, receipts and everything. And that data is being integrated to three different types of stage tables here. STG sales order, STG purchase order, STG invoice, all those things. And from this Oracle stage tables, we are loading the data finally into a data warehouse. You can say this is my data warehouse. VDS is nothing but the data warehouse. And wherein in this VDS schema, we have all these purchase order facts, sales order fact, and the necessary dimension tables also. I'll show you what are all the dimension tables. So in this document itself, if you scroll down, basically you have database scripts. You know, if you see here, these are all the dimension tables. DIM customer dimension, supplier dimension, item dimension, product dimension. These are all the different dimension tables. Say here also you can understand what are all the dimensions that you have and what are all the facts that you have. So basically the time is one dimension, product is one dimension. Customer, there are two types of customer. One is a bill to customer, another is a ship to customer. I mean, you are generating a bill and the ship to customer also, and you have a vendor and you have an organization. All these are all the different dimensions that you have as part of that. And you can say that these are all the fact tables which are there, but I have worked on only on the sales order fact and the purchase order fact. Don't just say that. If you say that I worked on all these things, they might ask you a lot of questions like what table it is, how you have designed and all those things. So you can say that I am more involved in the sales order, purchase order and the invoice fact. So these are all the different dimensions and fact tables which you have in the warehouse. Suppose to understand what are all the tables that are there, I mean, what is the database scripts that you have prepared, or if you want to understand what are all the measures that are there in the fact table. So people might ask you like, what is the measures that are there? So to understand that structure of the tables, you have this stage tables and these things. So you can see that if you go and open, here you have all the staging table details. So you have a staging table like STG forwarder, STG invoice, STG purchase order, STG vendor, all these things. These are all the staging tables. Similarly, if you look at the VDS thing, you also have fact tables here. So if you want to know what are all the measures that you have in the purchase order fact, you can understand from here. See here, cancelled quantity, received quantity, open quantity, ordered quantity. So these are all the measures which are there as part of a fact table, and these are all the dimension tables, supplier key, organization key, those are all the dimension tables what we have. And in the below also you have when they have requested and when you have forwarded, all these kind of a different dimensions which are there and which organization has booked it, and all these things are there as part of a fact table. So you need to also know the measurable columns which are there in the purchase order fact and also there in the sales order fact. So if you open in the sales order fact also, you have when you have requested, when you have sold, what is the invoice quantity, all shipped quantity, order quantity, cancel quantity, open quantity, what is the total value of the order, all these measures are being there as part of it. So when you explain about the project, what you need to concentrate more to the interviewer is that you need to explain, okay, we used to integrate the incremental data from my Oracle EBS into an Oracle 11G database, which is nothing but a staging database. We used to integrate the data into the staging area, and from staging area, we used to integrate into a data into an enterprise data warehouse, wherein we are maintaining the two types of facts, that is a purchase order fact and the sales order fact, what it is there. So, and out of this, there is a, you can say whatever the reporting tool that you are comfortable with, that reporting tool you can say what you know more about. So here in this project, business objects is being used as a reporting tool. There was a separate team which used to build the universe and then generate the reports from the data warehouse. But as an ETL developer, I didn't involve much in the, I didn't involve much in the business object side. So you can say that we have built I have involved in building the more than 10 to 15 mappings for integrating the data into the staging area. And from staging area to warehouse, I've built around 6 to 7 mappings. So among this, I've involved in implementing a SED type 1 mapping, SED type 2 mapping for a customer, and the two types of a fact table loads, which it is there. So this is how you need to explain. So once you, when you explain about the project, as I said, you should say what is your source system, which database, what Informatica tool, which version you have used, and what BO version also you should know. Okay, so don't just, they might ask you like which version of business objects is being used or not. So know the latest version or some earlier release, what is a business object. So let's say here the source database is in Oracle, right? And your staging database is also in Oracle, and your EDW database is also in Oracle. So if you have experience in terms of using any other database, you can say that maybe the source database, target database is in some other SQL server or Teradata. Or if you don't know, basically you can say that I worked mainly only using Oracle database. I haven't used other databases, something like SQL server and Teradata. So when you talk about Informatica, you can say that Informatica 951 or 961 is being used in this project. And business objects, I'm not very sure what version of business objects is there. So you can just say some version, whatever it is there. So this is how you explain. So when you talk about the roles and responsibilities, right? So what responsibilities that you have performed in a project, you can say that I have involved in preparing the design documents, okay? Preparing the design documents by understanding the requirements. So this design document is basically consists of details about the mappings and sessions, workflows, schedule of the sessions, all these things. And the second one is you can say that prepared the database scripts as per the data model. So if you are comfortable with the data model, you can say that I involved in the data model. Otherwise, you can say that data modeler was separate and we used to follow up with it. I mean, we used to get the data model from them to do that. So prepare the database scripts for creating the tables in staging and the EDW database, right? And you can say that third one, involved in building the mapping sessions and workflow, building the mappings session and workflows what we have with respect to that. And also you can say that I'm involved in the unit testing process. So whatever the unit testing process that we have learned as part of the course, you can say that, okay? And fifth one is closely interacted with the QA team for fixing the defects and all. Interacted with the QA team for fixing the defects. You can say that involved, preparing the migration document for moving the code to preparing the migration doc, for moving the code from development environment to higher environment and all those things, which you can say that. So these are all your roles and responsibilities. If you say that Informatica is installed in our Unix environment, I also know the basic shell scripting. So know the basic shell scripting and how to write and how to debug the basic shell scripts. So you can say that if you are aware of the third-party scheduling tools. So if you don't know, then you can say that Informatica itself is being used as a scheduler, and we used to invoke some of the jobs from the shell scripts. That's it, or a cron tab. That you can say that. So this is how you need to explain about the project end to end. So what roles and responsibilities you perform. So when you say that, they might ask you like, what kind of reports that your business users are generating. So mainly the reports will involve around the purchase order fact and the sales order fact, and they wanted to understand the purchase order expenses and the sales order revenue, profit, how much they are generating a profit. They were doing a profit analysis, purchase order analysis, sales order analysis with respect to the different dimensions, that is like customer, supplier, item, product, as well as the date. So this is how we have implemented. So there are different other type of fact tables also, but I didn't involve much of them, but there are the other fact tables like different fact tables also there, but I didn't involve. So that's how you can explain the complete process with respect to the project. Okay. So any questions you have out of these things what we discussed?
Yeah, actually one of my interview, they asked me that why we are using ETL tool. We can extract the data from by writing a simple query. So,
okay. So now the answer for that question is, suppose let's say if you have a SQL Server database or some other, I cannot transform the data within the query. Okay. So if I write a select statement, suppose if I want to do all the transformation logic, suppose like the grouping of the data or eliminating the duplicate records, all these kind of a complex things cannot be done within the select statement. So again, if you are writing a select statement, it will return the data. But how would I load the data by using a select statement? You cannot do that, right? So suppose this is there in the SQL Server and this is there in our Oracle database. So if I execute a select query here, how would I load the data? That is not possible. So when you are working with a heterogeneous databases, you cannot write a program to just to move the data from one database to other database. If it is a PL, both are Oracle. In this scenario, I can write a PLSQL program either in my staging database or the OLTP and move the data from OLTP to this. But when you are working with a heterogeneous databases, you must need a ETL tool, without which you can't do the ETL transformation or the logic.
Okay. And if I'm showing that I have 2 years of experience in Informatica, uh-huh. and then other person might ask me that what all scenarios, like what's like if you could maybe you would have find any difficult scenario within this time period. So how can I explain that?
Okay. So the people in general, they will ask you like what kind of a complex scenario that you have implemented. Okay. So that is, or a challenging task that you have implemented. So they will ask you. Okay. For this, we have actually explained you one scenario in the YouTube. Either you can take it, or so you probably have to spend another session to understand this. Okay. Because if I just have to explain a complex scenario, you should be able to understand whatever the scenario that I'm giving. Okay. So I can't just explain in 5 or 10 minutes to help you to make the understanding of the complex scenario. But at the time being, suppose if you want to get started, you can say that the complex task which I worked is, there was a scenario wherein we had to read the data from a flat file, and from the flat file, first 10 records in the flat file were about the header information, and last 5 records in the flat file is about the footer information, footer records. So now we had to build a simple mapping which will exclude these first 10 records and the last 5 records. So I have built a mapping or a ETL component for this to remove the first 10 records as well as the last 10 records. So, last 5 records. So how did you do? So the question is, if you have to remove the first 10 records, this can be done easily, wherein you can go in the file properties in the session, file properties in session, There you can specify how many number of rows to skip. If you edit it, there you can specify basically how many number of rows you want to skip. If you say that how many rows you want to skip, it will obviously skip the first how many number of rows you are specifying, that will be there. But how would you eliminate the last 5 records? You don't know how many number of records are there in the file. So in order to do this, you can say that I have implemented a mapping wherein I have used an expression transformation and generated a sequence number by using a variable port, right? And by using a variable port, and then I have used a sorter to sort the data based on the descending order by using the sequence number, whatever I have done. So when you do this, it will actually tilt it, you know, the first 5 records will come on the top. So first 5 records will come on the top, then you need to skip the first 5 records. So how would you do that? So again, for skipping this, you can say I have used another expression transformation, and this time I have generated another sequence number again by using this second sequence number. So you have generated one sequence number here and another sequence number here. So this sequence number is used to tilt the data. I mean, last record will become the first record, last but one record will become the second record. And this sequence number, again, it will generate the numbers from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here, I have used a filter condition. Within the filter, you can write the condition as second sequence number is less than or equal to 5. So something like this. I mean, you have to filter these records, right? So you can write the condition as where sequence number is greater than 6. So this is how I have excluded the records which are available in the footer, and then populated the data into the necessary target table. So this is a simple kind of a thing you can say, because your experience is just 2-year-old. They may not expect you much. You can say that this is a challenging task, but if you have to understand any complex scenario, you should have a minimum. I mean, I can give you a complex scenario, but you should be able to understand, because that requires a lot of a database knowledge and in terms of partitions and everything, and a lot of you know, the process knowledge as well. So once you're comfortable, then probably we have explained one scenario, probably you can go through that complex scenario which we have explained in the YouTube. So that will give you, for a time being, you can say that this was a challenging task which I got in my initial project. This is how I implemented that. That's how you can say. So if the people come back and say that, is this challenging? What is challenging in this? So you can say that logically, I mean, mapping wise it is simple, but logically I had to think and then do it. This was something that I felt challenging. That's it. That's how you can say. Right?
Okay. Okay.
Right. Any other questions you have?
You said in the workflow, you said that while transferring it to staging table and then into warehouse, we implemented SCD for type 1, type 2. So they might ask me that what kind of scenarios in which you use this SCD type 1 and type 2.
I said you, right? So you can say that for a DIM customer, we have used a type 2, and for a DIM product, we have used a type 2, and for a DIM vendor, we have used a type 1. So this is how you can say. So these are all the dimension tables what we have. So you can say that for these two dimension tables, we have type 2, and for this, we have a type 1. So out of this purchase order fact, I did show you what are all the, you know, the what are all the dimension tables and the fact tables here, right? So VDS final table. So out of that, you can pick one. You can say that, okay, this is two dimensions were type 2 and one dimension was a type 1. That's how you can say.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other question?
And how can we schedule a job through Unix, right?
Yeah. So scheduling is, as I explained in the class as well, so scheduling can be done from the third party tools. if you want to schedule within the Unix, there is something called as a cron tab. Okay, so by using a cron tab, we'll schedule the jobs in Unix, but invoking a workflow will be done by using a BMCMD, wherein we are going to keep the BMCMD in the shell script, and that shell script will be scheduled using a cron tab. Got it?
Okay. Okay.
Right. So let's say I'm creating a shell script called as a S1, and that S1 has to be executed at a 4 a.m. So S1 will be triggered by this cron tab at 4 a.m. when you schedule it. So when you open, you can just Google it. I mean, if you go here, right, here, sorry, I think if you say cron tab, you can basically understand. Cron tab. So it will tell you like how you have to schedule a job. All you need is, it's just very simple thing. You just need to, what is this? Okay. All you need to, on what day you want to do it, what time, all those things you can just define it. Okay. If you wanted to schedule a job in Unix. Okay. Now, if you want to schedule a job to run on this, okay. See, this is five, okay. You need to first understand the syntax, right? Okay. When you are giving the syntax, if you just use a cron tab minus E, it will tell you like what day you want to schedule, what hour, what minutes and everything. So for example, if you want to take the backup of your user accounts at 5 a.m. So on every week, so this is what it is. So you can give that syntax, month, hour, days, whatever. I mean, days, month, everything can be provided, and that will be automatically triggered. So from that, you can schedule the job using the cron tab. That's how it works.
Okay.
So if you want to see all the jobs, if you want to edit the cron tab job, you need to use -e. If you want to list all the cron tab jobs, you have to use cron tab -l. If you want to remove any cron job from that, you need to use cron tab -r. That's how you can do it.
Okay.
So here there is one more example. See, if you want to run a shell script on January 2nd at 6:15 a.m., this is how you need to do it. First is minutes, then hours. Second is a month, I mean day, and this is a month, and you just need to give. It's a 24-hour format, AM or PM. That's how you can do in a cron tab.
Okay.
Right. Any other questions?
No.
All right. All right then. So.